Hey, one of the big crises in here in this part of London is the concern about all the schools closing due to coronavirus and the children being at home for, what, 2-3 weeks? Who knows how long it's going to be? And the children are not allowed to go outside. The idea, the advice being given at the moment is that the children will be required to stay at home and to remain at home throughout this period as part of a kind of quarantining and seclusion. And so the crisis is not so much about the stockpiling of food and toilet roll and things like that, but rather the concern is education, because how will these children be educated whilst they are at home? Now, some of us have had a certain amount of experience of homeschooling, and we've done quite a lot of homeschooling. I mean, in our case, many years of it in one way or another. And so we have lots of homeschooling resources and running lessons and programs and things like that. But no, the vast majority have never done anything like it and are completely intimidated by it and more concerned about this than almost anything else, so certainly some of the parents. But it's an interesting moment to think about what is the purpose of education. Now, in our day, lots of education seems to be geared simply towards getting a job. And even in school assemblies, there's been that horrible business of having someone who's like a self-employed business person who's made a lot of money, and then saying to the children, look, if you work really hard at school and dedicate your life, you could end up like this. As if the highest thing that a child could aspire to is earning lots of money and having a big house and a new car and things like that. And really, that is a form of child abuse, because let's remember, each child was designed to live the life of God, to walk among the stars and judge angels and participate in the highest heaven and drink from the fountain of life to all eternity, to exist forever. Every human being will exist when all the companies and multinationals have long since disappeared, even when all the empires of the world have gone. Human beings, every human being still exists one way or another. So as Jesus said, a single human soul is worth more than the entire world. Even if you could gain the whole world, he said. But if you lose one human soul, it's not worth it. So that is how he viewed individual human beings. And then often in mainstream education, it's geared tremendously around these notions of employment and getting a job, that sort of thing. Now, there's much older traditions of education available where education is about becoming a human being who is able to be mature, and education has got a lot more to do with the formation of character, of the issues of the heart, how to become a mature human being who understands what human life is all about. So here's my thought. If you're one of the parents who's very anxious because you're thinking, I haven't got resources to learn biology, chemistry, maths, physics, English, French, all these subjects. Well, look, I don't know, maybe the schools will give you some resources. Here's my advice. Don't worry about that kind of education. If you've got your children at home with you for the next 2 or 3 weeks, instead of seeing it as a terrible burden and a crisis, why not see it as a tremendous opportunity to educate your children in true wisdom? To have some time where you're forced to be together and they are forced to kind of learn from you. And why not find out what true wisdom is? What is it that a human being is really supposed to be educated in? What does it mean to be truly human? What is human life for? Why were we designed? What is our destiny? Why not return to the scriptures? The Bible, Old and New Testaments, the Book of Proverbs. Find out where wisdom begins. What? Have a look at that. What is the beginning of wisdom? And then what does that mean? When you find the answer, and you will quite quickly, what does that mean? What does that mean? How would we bring that about? Who is this Lord God? Look at Proverbs chapter 8. Who is this craftsman of all creation who was with the Lord before the world began and put in place all the boundaries of creation and holds it all together? Come to this one, Jesus Christ, who is called the wisdom of God. Find out why entire civilizations have been built on following this one, who is the true God and true humanity all bundled up together. Why is it that entire civilizations have been based on him, and these universities, now they've kind of forgotten him. I understand that. But they were based on him, the great universities of the world. So take this opportunity where you may have to homeschool for 2 or 3 weeks, not as a burden, but as a tremendous opportunity for you and your children to get a real education, to discover what real wisdom is.